What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name's Daymon Warren, and this is Day One Tech. And today, I'm going to go over the DJI Mic 2 transmitter. Now, this transmitter, this microphone, has got a lot of options. And one of the big challenges that I ran across, and hopefully I'll be able to help you out with it, is it has the Bluetooth capability and switching it between different devices. Now, these are the devices that I use on a general shoot when I go out to shoot my vlog. And I like to use the one microphone. And the one microphone I like to use is the DJI Mic 2. And I just picked up a second one. And then I also picked up the lavalier mic. Now, this lavalier mic, I really like a couple things that it does. It's got that L when it connects, and you can swing it underneath on the two, so it holds it in there nice. And also, this actually swivels, so you get 360 degrees to turn it, so I don't have to, I can just put it wherever I need it and then adjust the mic. So that lavalier, I think it was definitely worth the money, and then the way that that pops on. But the syncing, because I got this aftermarket, so I had the Mic 1, and then I bought the Pocket. So I will show you the basic operation of this. So first off, what I usually do, you turn it on. Now, without any equipment being on, you can just turn it on and hit the red button. That's letting you know that it's recording on the internal memory right there. So right now it's recording internally. I don't need to pair it to anything else. I can use it just like that. Now let's say you press it again and it stops. Now let's say I want to hook it up using the receiver that came with it. So I have it on. Turn on the receiver. You notice that this is flashing blue, but the receiver is not receiving it. So when it's on, to switch the modes, so basically it has two modes. It has a Bluetooth mode and then a pairing with the receiver. You're going to press and hold the record button. So press and hold that red button, and you'll see this change from blue. Takes about 10 seconds to green. When it goes green, now it's hooked into the receiver. So this microphone is now hooked into that receiver. I can see the levels, no problem. Man, the next thing is, I'm not using a receiver. I might use my Pocket. So I got the Pocket right here. I'm gonna turn the screen, it's gonna turn on. And it's not showing me the levels. So now what you're gonna do, you're gonna press and hold the button, switch your modes, hold it, press and hold it, it goes into blue. Now, see how this is like a kind of a steady blue? You're gonna press and hold this link button right here. Press and hold that link button, and then it's gonna start flashing fast. Hey, you're gonna go into your settings, wireless mic, touch the one that you want to link it to, and since this is flash, it's connected. We'll let you know that it's connected right there. Hit confirm, and now we have levels on the Pocket. Nice and easy. I can do all my settings right here. There's actually more settings on the Pocket than using the app. So let's say I'm not going to use the Pocket now. I'm going to use a cell phone. So I'm going to go into Bluetooth, turn my Bluetooth on. And you notice that this blue is doing a steady flash, which means it's not connected in Bluetooth. All right, so I'm going to press and hold the link button. Press and hold that link button. It starts flashing fast. And I'm going to press the DJI mic right there. Right there, it says DJI mic, and now I am connected. Steady flash, says connected. Now, one thing about using the iPhone, if you use the regular camera app, it doesn't really use the Bluetooth sound. So it's not using this Bluetooth microphone for the sound. Or at least at the time of this doing this recording. And if you use the Final Cut, the new Final Cut Pro app, go into settings, audio, and it doesn't give you the option for the Bluetooth. The best app that I've been using is the Blackmagic app right here. This is a free app. And I'll show you from the main camera here. All right, so you're in the main camera here. This is in the Blackmagic here. You hit this settings over to the left. You see audio, audio source. And then you'll have your choice of iPhone microphone or the DJI. Once that's selected as the DJI, you'll now see that the levels are going as I'm hitting the microphone. So that's one of the things. The Blackmagic video app is probably the best one out there, paid or free. For all the options you get with it, it works my favorite, especially with the microphone. I'm going to use my Insta360 X4. And yes, it will work with the Insta360 X4. So see how this microphone is very versatile between the different devices. So in order to set it up, pull down, slide over. See those headphones right there? Press on those headphones. And now I want to go into pairing mode on the mic. Press and hold the link button. Starts flashing fast. Okay, and there it is. So now I have this microphone hooked up. With the X4. So now the X4 is recording using the DJI Mic 2. And you can tell it's using it. Up at the top there, you see the headphones. You don't get any levels, but that's okay. Four, show you on the Action 4 here. And it's pretty much the same way you do. I got my flashing blue. Press and hold the link. Get quick flash. And I'm going to hit this microphone right here. So on the settings, wireless mic. And they're both in pairing mode. Will take a couple seconds. Goes solid. Transmitter's connected. Confirm. And now I have levels using the DJI Mic 2. And there it is. That's how easy and simple it is to connect the DJI Mic 2 to a number of devices. Nice, quick, easy. And you can always use the internal recording while you're synced to the other devices. And if you use the, you can set up the mic to do what's called 32 float, and which is basically like it has a cushion. So if you're going to be, let's say, fireworks or something, and it might get loud, 32 float protects the sound. So instead of the sound getting distorted, it won't be distorted. So a lot of times if I'm going to a live event, I will do the internal recording to protect the sound, just in case I get to a part and the sound is too loud and it gets distorted. But yeah, it's really good. You can buy just the receiver for around $100. That's how I bought this one. So when I do interviews and different things, I can have one for the person I'm interviewing and one for myself. And the model with the kit with the microphone and the receiver was around $160. And two microphones and a receiver, I'm not sure on that price. But I'll put the links in the description. If you have any questions, hit me up. I'll try to get an answer for you. Thanks for watching this video. And please hit that like button. And subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Really do appreciate it, and it helps out the channel a lot. So until next video, remember, take care of each other. Peace out. And I'll see you all soon.